I'm about to show you how to quickly and easily remove flicker from your videos in DaVinci Resolve, guaranteed, and take your videos from looking like this, with lights flickering in the background all over the place, to this, zero flicker and looking incredible. This video also has a sponsor, it's my friends at Soundstripe. Look, we as video editors and filmmakers all need music for our videos, right? Well, in my experience, even whenever I find an audio track that I love, I usually need to tweak it some, either by making it a bit longer or a bit shorter, or adding or removing a few elements. You know what I mean. Well, in the past, that required a lot of clicks and a lot of fine-tuning to get a song sounding just right in my video editor. But Soundstripe just made things a whole lot easier with their new AI song editing tool that enables you to edit any track on their website in seconds with extremely high quality results, and you don't even have to be an audio engineer to do it. All you have to do is click on the edit button and you will see that a song has been split into different sections, and you can then rebuild the song using any of those sections in any order that you want, completely remixing things and enabling you to get the exact sound that you want in just a few clicks. Then you can download your custom audio track that you built exactly to your specifications and use it in your video, saving you hours of work. To get this AI song editing tool for yourself, all you have to do is go to my link to Soundstripe in the video description, sign up for a pro plan, and you'll be remixing any song on their site in seconds. And when you sign up, be sure to use the coupon code WHOISMATT10 to save 10% on your purchase. Now, what are you waiting for? Go sign up for Soundstripe. Let's start with the basic and most common flicker removal method that there are already a ton of tutorials out there on the internet for, but I want to make sure we cover. This is the clip duplication method to remove flicker. And the good news is that it works with the free version of DaVinci Resolve. All you have to do is put your video clip that has flicker with it on the timeline here. And as you can see, this is from a wedding with a ton of flicker on the couple's outfits in the background, just flicker all over the place, right? And if you want to remove that flicker, all you have to do is go down to your video clip, hold down the Alt key on Windows or Command key on Mac, and drag up to then duplicate the clip. Then we're going to press Control Plus to zoom in, going to move the video clip over one frame, then go up to Inspector, down to Composite, set the opacity to 60%, hit play, check it out. Boom, look how much cleaner that is, no flicker. What? Isn't that great? As a bonus tip though, which I actually learned from Mad Music Lines comment on my flicker removal tutorial for Adobe Premiere Pro, if you are still seeing some flicker, like on these lights here in the background, you can see that we got a bit of flicker back here. Okay, how do we remove that? Well, here is the tip. All you need to do is go back down to your video clip on the timeline, to the second clip, hold down that Command or Alt key again, drag up again to duplicate it, move it over to the right one more time. Then for the clip inspector, turn this third clip that we have here to an opacity of 30%. So now I have one clip that's fully opaque, another clip that's 60% opacity, and a third clip that is 30% opacity. Hit play, boom, looking cleaner, right? Even less flicker. By all means, try this method first, but what if you're dealing with some really stubborn flicker and you're telling me, Matt, I've already seen this duplication tip and it didn't fix it? Well, you're going to love this next flicker removal technique, but I will warn you, you will need the paid studio version of DaVinci Resolve to access it. Here's how it works. All you need to do is bring your clip in that has flicker to it onto your timeline, just like we did earlier. In this case, it's some people dancing at a wedding. I filmed this 240 frames per second, tons of flicker just overhead from lights in the background. And you can see everybody's kind of blinking in a little bit because of all the flicker. Next, instead of duplicating the clip, we're gonna go up here to the effects panel and go to search, and we're gonna search for Deflicker and make sure that you're actually on the open effects tab here, otherwise it's not gonna show up. There's Deflicker, drag it down here to the video clip. And once you do that, click on the video clip and you can go over here to the inspector on the right to the effects icon, and here is the Deflicker settings. Now, unfortunately, by default, as you can see here, the Deflicker effect is going to be set to time lapse, which is great if you need to remove flicker from a time lapse. But in the case of this tutorial, we're trying to remove flicker from cheap LED lights. So in this case, we're gonna want to click the drop down button and select fluorolite, which stands for fluorescent lighting. But don't worry, this is a catch-all term here, okay? It's also gonna cover cheap LED lighting flicker as well, which is probably what you're gonna be dealing with more often. By you choosing this setting, for most lights, the flicker should be fixed immediately. Hit play, wow, look at that, it's clean. Fantastic. We just had to do one thing and it's done. Cool. Love it. Awesome. But if you are still experiencing flicker, I have good news. There's an advanced controls mode here. If we go up here to our Deflicker settings, go here to advanced controls, we have a lot more settings here to talk about. And these are some very helpful tools that I'm gonna show you how to tweak now to remove more stubborn flicker. And in addition, if these advanced tools do not help, I have a completely separate tool that I can basically guarantee will remove flicker from your videos, but we're gonna talk about that in a moment. For now, let's dive into these advanced controls. And the first thing you need to know is that there are so many factors that affect flicker, from the kind of lights that are being used to your frame rate and shutter speed, etc., that it's essentially impossible for me to tell you the absolute best settings to choose here that'll fix everything. But what I can do is tell you what some of the most important of these settings do and recommend some tweaks for them so you can see if changing them helps fix your problem. To start, you have frames on either side, which by default is set to 3, and basically means that whenever Resolve is attempting to remove flicker, it's gonna look 3 frames ahead and 3 frames behind by default to find flickering in different parts of your image. If you are noticing that you have a slower flicker that's not being fixed by this effect, feel free to increase the number of frames to 5, and this may help fix your issue. Next, you have motion estimation type, and by default, this is set to better, but if you have a highly detailed scene with a lot of intricate things that are flickering, the better mode may actually not be better for you, and instead you'll want to choose faster, which will not analyze the detailed image as much and may actually work better. In addition, if you do not have any motion in your shot at all, it's a completely locked off tripod shot, feel free to set this to none, and that may fix all the flicker right there for you. Next, down here, you have motion range, and this is going to help Resolve know if the flicker has a small amount of motion or a large amount of motion. So feel free to click through these settings too and play back your video clip to see if that fixes things as well. Now there are more settings here as well, including luma threshold and chroma threshold, and these basically determine how aggressive the flicker reduction is going to be, and by default these are set to the maximum sensitivity, which is really where I would leave them. But in the event that your video is looking weird because there's actually too much flicker reduction happening, feel free to turn these sliders down. You also have some speed optimization settings here that you can adjust to make the deflicker effect work faster, but in my experience, I would avoid changing these. That said though, a tool that I would consider using is this restore original detail after deflicker setting. Because you have to remember, whenever your video has flicker removed, it can get softer. So this effect slider will add a sharpening to the video clip. If things don't look sharp enough though, feel free to drag up to increase it. If they look too sharp, drag it down to decrease it. Lastly, you have one of my favorite and most useful settings for this effect. You can go to this output drop down menu here, and by default, it's going to be set to deflickered result. But if you want to be able to visually see exactly what flicker is being removed from the video, you can choose detected flicker, and Resolve will create a mask overlay that shows you exactly which parts of your video are having flicker removed. In this case, you can see some flicker over here blinking on the side over here, and you're like, Matt, that's not super clear. Well, guess what? We have another alternative here. If you go over here to output and select magnified flicker, that's going to make everything even sharper so you can really see the flicker being removed. See all that blinking? That is being removed by this deflicker effect, and it's working really well. But now I hear you telling me, Matt, I have some ultra stubborn flicker and it's not going away. Help me, please. Okay, first, let me get the bad news out of the way. You're going to need to buy a plugin called Flicker Free from a company called Digital Anarchy. And at the time of making this video, this plugin cost $149. I wish this plugin was free, but I promise you it works. And whenever I made a different video featuring this plugin in Premiere Pro, you can look at the comments on that video. Everyone that has used this plugin says that it does work and it is worth it. Also, side note, this video is not paid or sponsored by Digital Anarchy, who makes Flicker Free or anything like that. I chose to make this video on my own because I really do want to help you remove flicker. That said, I am an affiliate though, and so if you purchase the plugin using my link, I will get a kickback. Just wanted to be clear there. Lastly, here is the great news. They do offer a free trial of this plugin that is available. So if you're telling me, Matt, hey, $140 seems like a pretty high price, right? And how do I actually know it's gonna work? Well, you go over here to the try option. You can scroll down here, and here are flicker-free demos for Premiere Pro, for DaVinci Resolve, for Avid. You got all the demos here. These are Windows demos. Go up here to Mac download demos, scroll down. Oh, look, we have flicker-free demos for Mac as well. So you have demos here that you can test out, and then they will let you apply the effect to your footage to confirm that the flicker will actually be removed before you buy it, which I think is really great, because that way you're not wasting money if it doesn't actually work. But like I said, I have yet to find flicker footage that this plugin has not been able to fix, so you're probably good with it. Anyways, let's talk about Flicker Free and how to use it. First, you're gonna wanna download Flicker Free and install it, and then whenever you have a video clip with very stubborn flicker that does not want to be removed in any other way in DaVinci Resolve, which for this clip here, as you can see, it is difficult. We have flicker really fast over here. We got slow flicker over here. We got a little bit of flicker on the couple as well. This is just a rough clip to try to remove flicker from. But Flicker Free can do it. So to add the Flicker Free plugin, what we're going to do is go over here to our effects panel again. Instead of Deflicker, we're just going to want to search for regular Flicker. There is Flicker Free under Digital Anarchy. Drag it down to our video clip. And what the heck is going on? Why are there all these lines? Well, a little peek behind the curtain here for you. I purchased the Premiere Pro version of this plugin years ago because I hadn't really considered using DaVinci Resolve at the time. But now here we are. And suddenly I don't own the DaVinci Resolve version of this plugin. So guess what? I'm using the trial version just like I was recommending that you do, which is going to fully work and show us how it works. It's just going to have this overlay here unless I buy the plugin. Hit play now, check out the video, and wait a second, this video still has Flicker, and that's because Flicker Free is a very customizable plugin and you're going to need to tweak some settings. But like I said, once we get these settings dialed in, it is going to work for you. First off, you're going to want to go over to your inspector window to the effects tab here to the Flicker Free effect, and you're going to see that you have a ton of different presets that you can select from here. It's going to be set to rolling bands, which usually works pretty well, but if it doesn't work, please feel free to click through these other presets and see if one of them makes things work better. In my rather extensive experience with this plugin now, I've found that the slow motion preset works really well for Flicker. So if we apply that now and hit play again, you're going to see that the Flicker has been improved, but there's also some weird motion blurring, especially on the couple as they're dancing. So to fix that, you can click on this motion compensation checkbox, and that's going to then remove the ghosting effect, and suddenly they look dramatically sharper and better. That's starting to look good, but here we are still dealing with this very intense flicker in the background from these lights. Thankfully, here is the trick for how you can fix really stubborn flicker. The secret is that you do not have to apply this Flicker Free plugin once. You can apply it multiple times to make the effect even stronger. That said, I would not recommend going over here and dragging the Flicker Free effect down to your video clip again. That's going to dramatically slow down your software or possibly freeze it up and crash it. Ask me how I know. It has happened to me a lot. So to avoid that happening, I would instead apply one pass of Flicker Free to your video clip, then render out that video clip from DaVinci Resolve and re-import it back into Resolve to apply the effect again. Then with this re-imported clip that we've made one flicker removal pass on, as you can see, it's looking significantly better with the couple having no flicker, but the background still having flicker from those lights. Well, now we're going to want to go back over here to our effects again, go back to the Flicker Free effect, drag it back down to our video clip on the timeline to apply it again. And in this case, we're going to select the slow motion preset and change the threshold all the way up to 100 to make it very strong. And then we're going to hit play and check it out. Now the flicker from those lights in the back is truly gone, but oh boy, there is a ton of motion blur. So yet again, let's turn on the motion compensation checkbox again, hit play again, and dang it, while that has removed the motion blur, well, the flicker is also back as well. So here is the final trick. You can use masking in DaVinci Resolve to only make the Flicker Free effect apply to specific parts of your image, and it's super easy to do. So first, you actually want to go over here and disable the Flicker Free effect from your video clip because it's going to slow down your computer. You want to apply it after. Okay, we're going to re-enable it here in just a second. Then we're going to go over here to the color page in DaVinci Resolve, which we have our nodes here. We have all of our settings over here. And let's think about what we're trying to do here. The issue is that our subject in this video clip, the couple, is looking really blurry whenever we apply this effect with all this ghosting due to the Flicker Free plugin. So what we ideally want to do is make it so that the couple does not have the effect applied to them. And there's a lot of ways that you can do this in DaVinci Resolve. You can go down here and create a custom mask around the couple and be like, okay, here they are. We'll make a little box around them. Really, really rough here, right? And be like, don't affect them here. And we can like try to feather it a ton and like be like, look, it's fine. I don't really like doing things that way, okay? Here's a much easier way. If you have the studio version of Resolve, you can do this dramatically more easily with this magic mask effect. All you have to do is select magic mask, go up here and click and drag on your subject. In this case, it's a couple. And I'm just gonna draw a really rough line here around them. Be like, hey, yeah, this is what I want you to focus on. Okay, Resolve, you got that? And Resolve will be like, okay, cool, got you, no sweat. So click that, let go. And you're like, Matt, did it work? Did it work? Well, if you're not clear whether it worked or not, go down here and click on this little toggle mask overlay and check that out. Suddenly the couple is lit up red Everything else around them is not lit up. So that means that we have now told Resolve to create a mask just over the couple, which is super cool. And now any effect that we add to this video clip will only apply to the couple. And wait a second. No, we don't want it to apply to the couple. We want to apply the effect to the background. So to get around that, here's what's so great. All you have to do is go down here to this button that says Invert Mask. Click on that. Suddenly, our couple is isolated. They are not what we have selected. Now the entire background is selected, including all of that flicker. Isn't that great? Then all you have to do is go up here to this effects panel right here for this specific node in the color page, and we're going to search for Flicker Free again. There it is. And we're going to apply it to this node in particular, and then choose slow motion, crank up the threshold all the way, leave motion compensation turned off because that was giving us an issue, hit play on our video, boom. And just like that, the effect has been applied to only the background, not the subject, and the couple is looking very sharp where the background has no flicker at all. And that's how you quickly and easily remove flicker in DaVinci Resolve. Remember, I've linked to that flicker-free plugin in the video description if you want to download a trial to test out completely for free. And while you're down there, I'll also link in the description to my Edit Videos Like a Pro guide. This guide is going to show you some of the most important tips that took me years to learn as a video editor. And if you edit in DaVinci Resolve, I think they're going to be super helpful to you as well. Please like this video and subscribe if you want to see more helpful filmmaking tips in the future. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.